Welcome to a demonstration of Keysight's PathWave ADS, specifically the SIPro workflow for DDR memory systems. We'll start with a board that's been imported from an enterprise layout tool. This PCB is a DDR4 SODIMM-based design provided to us by Seiko. Seiko is a leader in embedded system design for medical imaging, industrial automation, and more. Before you perform any EM simulation, it's important to open up the substrate stack-up and check the overall substrate height. Next, you want to check the material properties and make sure that you've got the correct dielectric permittivity as well as surface roughness. Next, we'll launch SIPro. As you can see, it has a modern 3D user interface. In order to greatly reduce simulation setup time, SIPro has a DDR setup wizard. As you select components in the PCB layout, they're added to the setup wizard, and the setup wizard then calculates all the possible DDR connections between those devices. We're going to add in now additional address nets so that we can focus in on a feature of SIPro that allows us to specify a reference power plane. Once we press Generate Setup, it's going to create a new DDR analysis in the workspace tree. Let's scroll through the analysis and find the additional nets that we added. Once we've highlighted them, we can peel away the layers of the PCB and focus in just on the transmission lines and vias. Let's visualize the power plane. You can see that the closest pin to our command address net is VDD. SIPro has automatically created an EM port across those two pins, capturing the return current path accurately. As a reference, we've provided some simulation stats without parallelism being used. Once a simulation is finished, we can automatically generate a schematic so that we can use these results in a system simulation. Memory Designer is a comprehensive workflow for DDR. As we click into the printed circuit board, you can see that it's referencing our EM result from before. Memory Designer makes it simple to connect tens of nets to each other between components. With just one click, we're able to connect across tens of nets at once. Connections are made by automatically matching signal IDs, and it even gives you visual feedback if some of the data is inconsistent. Setting up models for transmit or receive becomes very easy as we click into the memory device component. We define how many devices we wish to enable, and then we define how many signal nets we wish to simulate. On the Model Setup tab, you have the ability to select a model from the IBIS file. This model provides the undie termination as well as additional jitter and equalization. The memory probe is special because it allows you to access the signals in any of the smart components without needing to wire anything up. We will save time by selecting groups of signals at specific locations where we want to measure, and then setting up specific measurements for each group. Something that's unique to Memory Designer is the ability to launch Keysight's compliance apps. There are three different simulation types that can be run from the same schematic. First is transient SPICE simulation. Second is a statistical DDR bus simulation. Third, specifically for DDR5, is an enhanced AMI simulation in bit-by-bit mode. The flexible data display enables us to look at our eye diagrams and waveforms in one place. When Memory Designer launches the Keysight compliance app, and they use the same measurement algorithms as would be used with real hardware on a test prototype. This concludes our demonstration of the SIPro and Memory Designer workflow for DDR. Thanks for watching.